बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग आवर प्रैक्टिकल पोर्शन ऑफ द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ मोलर मोलल एंड नॉर्मल सॉल्यूशंस। टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ मोलल सॉल्यूशन मोलल एंड वी विल स्टडी द थ्योरी ऑफ दिस सॉल्यूशन। फर्स्ट मोलल सॉल्यूशन, द नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ सॉल्यूट डिसॉल्व्ड पर किलोग्राम ऑफ सॉल्वेंट। Here you note please that here I am using the term kilogram of solvent. This is called molality and it is indicated by small m. By kilogram of solvent means here you are taking the solvent by weight. In molality you have taken the molar solvent by volume, and we use the word solution. Here we are using the word solvent. So number of moles of solute dissolved per kilogram of solvent, it means we are taking the weight of the solvent, is called molality. It is indicated by small m. If one mole of solute is dissolved in 1 kilogram of solvent, the solution is called as one molal solution, MOLAL, molal solutions. So molality is equal to number of moles of solute per kilogram of solvent, or is you can write it as m is equal to n by w of solvent. W of solvent means weight of solvent. Now we will study some examples. Prepare 1 molal solution of sodium hydroxide. So 1 molal means we are taking the mole of sodium hydroxide as we have taken in our molarity equation. So 1 mole of sodium hydroxide is equal to 40 gram, but here we will dissolve the sodium hydroxide in 40 instead of 1000 ml, we dissolve it in 1000 gram of water. It means first you will measure the volume weight of the, you will take the weight, suppose this is the digital balance, so you will put the flask over it and weigh the water. When it will become 1000 gram, then you will add sodium hydroxide in it. By adding sodium hydroxide in this 1000 gram of water, the level of the water may increase from this point. So you can say that suppose this is the measuring flask and this is the leveling point where the 1000 ml will become. So but here in this molality solution, when you will add 40 gram of sodium hydroxide in 1000 gram of water, then the volume of water may rise from this mark, which was initially marked over this measuring flask at 1000 ml point. So volume may increase. In this way we say that molality is temperature independent and the volume of the solution may increase or decrease from 1000 ml, as I have shown you in this diagram. That volume is increased from this level to this level. So this is due to the weight of the solvent. So prepare, next is the prepare 0.1 m sodium hydroxide. For this for the preparation of this solution, we will take the formula amount of solute per 1000 gram of solvent. This is equal to molality into molar mass. We want to prepare the molal 0.1 molal solution, multiply this with 40, The answer will 4 gram. It means you will dissolve 4 gram of sodium hydroxide in 1000 gram of water to prepare 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide solution. Next is the normality. You have to prepare the normal solution. So firstly we will study the normality. The number of gram equivalent of solute dissolved per liter of solution is known as normality. If 1 gram equivalent of solute is dissolved per liter of solution, it is called as 1 normal solution. Normality is indicated by capital N. So first we will define the term gram equivalent. Gram equivalent is defined as the equivalent weight of a substance expressed in grams is called gram equivalent. Gram equivalent measures the reactive capacity of the molecule. First, then we will define the equivalent weight to understand the gram equivalent. And when we will understand the gram equivalent, then we can easily understand the definition of normality. So now we define the word equivalent weight. The parts by weight of a substance that combines with or displaces. Shamil hoti hai aur ya nikalti hai. Combines with or displaces. Directly or indirectly. 1.008 parts by weight. P by W means parts by weight of hydrogen. 8 parts by weight of oxygen. Or 35.5 parts by weight of chlorine. These are the masses of these atoms. Atomic mass of hydrogen is 1.008. Oxygen is 8. And of chlorine is 35.5. So you can well understand this term equivalent weight by these examples. Equivalent weight of an acid can be found out by molecular weight divided by replaceable hydrogen ion of the acid. Replaceable means ionizable, which can be removed. Which can be removed from the acid. As we know that when you will dissolve HCl in water, it will ionize in this form. It will give H positive ion and Cl ion, one hydrogen ion. But when you will dissolve sulfuric acid in water, it will displace two hydrogen ions. So these two hydrogen ions are replaceable hydrogen ions or removable hydrogen ions. As in sulfuric acid, there are two removable or displaceable hydrogen ions. We will divide the molar mass of sulfuric acid, which is 98 by 2, it will become 49. So the equivalent weight of sulfuric acid is 49. 98 is the molar mass of sulfuric acid. When here in normality equation, or to find solve this normality equation, we will use the equivalent weight, which is 49 for the sulfuric acid. Equivalent weight of base can be found out that molecular weight divided by replaceable hydrogen ions of the base. Replaceable means removable. Here in the case of sodium hydroxide, we know that NaOH, in NaOH, the removable hydroxide ion is 1. It will ionize in this form. But in case of calcium hydroxide, it will ionize in this form, calcium plus 2OH ion. This calcium plus 2OH ion, these two OH ions are removable. or replaceable ovechains. The replaceable ovechain is known as acidity of the base, and replaceable hydrogen ions are known as basicity of the acid. For example, equivalent weight of sodium hydroxide is 40 and it has only one replaceable hydroxide ion, so we will divide it by 1, it will become 40. But equivalent weight of calcium hydroxide is 74. Molar mass of calcium hydroxide is 74. You will divide it by 2, it will become 34. So the equivalent weight of calcium hydroxide will become 34. Next, we will study a few examples for the preparation of sodium normal solutions. First is the prepare 1N solution of sodium hydroxide. Equivalent weight of sodium hydroxide is 40. Dissolve 40 gram of sodium hydroxide to make the volume 1 liter. As the molar mass of sodium hydroxide and equivalent weight of sodium hydroxide is same because it has only one replaceable hydroxide ion. Second one is the prepare 0.1N solution of sodium hydroxide. As we know that equivalent weight of sodium hydroxide is 40, to prepare 0.1N solution of sodium hydroxide, we will dissolve 0.1 gram equivalent of sodium hydroxide. To get the 0.1 gram equivalent, we will divide the molar mass with 10. So it will become 4. Dissolve 4 gram of sodium hydroxide to make the volume of 1 liter for 0.1N solution. Next is the prepare 0.1N solution of sulfuric acid. As we have studied in molarity lecture that commercially available acids have their own molarity and normality. The normality of commercially available sulfuric acid is 36N. So we can make the 0.1N solution from this 36N sulfuric acid. Write the formula in the given sulfuric acid and the required sulfuric acid. This is known as the normality equation, as we have studied the molarity equation, which was M1V1 is equal to M2V2. Here this is the normality equation. We are replacing M1 by N1. N1V1 is equal to N2V2. Write N1 36, which is given sulfuric acid normality. 36V1 is equal to 0.1, which we want to prepare, multiplied by 1000. So the volume will become 2.8 milliliter per liter. It means to prepare 0.1N sulfuric acid solution, we will dissolve 2.8 ml from this commercially available sulfuric acid. We will take 2.8 ml from this commercially available sulfuric acid and dissolve it in the water to make the volume up to 1 liter. Always use the distilled water for the preparation of the solution. Next is prepare 0.01N solution of sulfuric acid. As here is given 0.01N, so we will take the 0.01 gram equivalent of sodium hydroxide. To make this 0.01 gram, we will divide it by 100. As 0.01 means 1 by 100, 0.01 means 0.01 is equal to 1 by 100. So we will divide it by 100. Dissolve this 0.4 gram of sodium hydroxide to make the volume 1 liter for 0.01 and solution. This is all about the normality or normal solution. Next, we will study the experimental work. How can we prepare this solution in lab? So, as an example, I am telling you the preparation of 0.1 mm sodium hydroxide solution. We have studied it in our previous lecture. We will inshallah perform these practicals in our lab. But here we are studying only the theory work. The material required: sodium hydroxide solid, distilled water, and the apparatus will be watch glass, measuring flask. Measuring flask, as we want to prepare 0.1 mm, so it means we will use the 1000 ml measuring flask, funnel, beaker, and spatula. Procedure: first, we will calculate the mass of sodium hydroxide required to make 1000 ml of 0.1 solution. We will calculate the mass, as I have told you in previous lecture, of molarity. So molar mass of sodium hydroxide is 40. Number of moles of sodium hydroxide required will be 0.1 mole, as the concentration is 0.1 molarity. So we will use the 0.1 mole, and we will convert this 0.1 mole into gram by using the formula N is equal to weight of the solute divided by molar mass of solute. Weight of solute will be N into molar mass, 0.1 mm into 40, 4 gram. Weigh 4 gram of sodium hydroxide on the digital balance. It means you will take the sodium hydroxide pellets. Pellets mean chote-chote iski balls hoti hain. You will take the 4 gram of sodium hydroxide and weigh it on the digital balance. Put sodium hydroxide for weighing it. You will put the sodium hydroxide on the pre-weighed watch glass. It means pre-weighed watch glass means first you will weigh the watch glass, then add the sodium hydroxide 4 gram with the help of spatula on the pre-weighed sodium watch glass. Then transfer this sodium hydroxide in a beaker. This sodium hydroxide means when you will measure the weight the sodium hydroxide, then put it in this type of apparatus which is known as beaker. 4 gram of sodium hydroxide and add a little water over it to dissolve this sodium hydroxide in this water, and this will change into the solution form. Then transfer this sodium hydroxide in the beaker and add small amount of water so that all the sodium hydroxide dissolve. Then transfer this solution to the measuring flask, 1000 ml measuring flask, this type of measuring flask. Transfer this solution in this way, add more distilled water to raise the level up to this point. This is the mark which is which is put over this measuring flask, and shake the flask well. When you will add this solution which you made it in the beaker, put and transfer it in the measuring flask, add more water in it, and then shake this flask well. Put the stopper over it, and lastly label this flask as it has 0.1 mm sodium hydroxide solution. Generally some labeling point is available on this flask at this point, and we write the concentration over it by the removable pen. When you will use it, then this solution, and when we wash this flask, we wash this measurement again for reuse it. So this is all about the today's lecture. I think you have understand it, and inshallah we will perform all these practicals in our lab. Thank you.